Southern resident killer whales and transient killer whales are different ecotypes. So what that means is they're different genetically, they have different dialects, they don't interbreed, and they have completely different diets. Southern resident killer whales eat Chinook salmon, as where transient killer whales prey upon marine mammals like seals, sea lions, dolphins, porpoises, and even whales. We've noticed a shift here in the Salish Sea. It used to be that when you went whale watching or out on a boat, if you saw killer whales, you were most likely to see the southern resident killer whales. And it was pretty uncommon to see transients. But over the past decade, that's totally switched. Now, people are seeing transients all over the place while sightings of the residents are decreasing significantly. That has everything to do with prey availability. It used to be legal to hunt and kill seals and sea lions in Washington State in America, but in 1972, the Marine Mammal Protection Act was enacted into law and offered protection to pinnipeds like seals and sea lions. And since that time, these populations have completely recovered and are thriving. And as we see an increase in the seal and the sea lion population, we are seeing more and more sightings of transients in our waters, to the point we're starting to see transients in the waters that have never been seen here before. And I think this is really interesting, because the thing about transients is they're exposed to the same exact threats that the residents are. They're exposed to vessel noise and vessel traffic. They're exposed to pollution. And in fact, they actually have more toxins stored in their body than southern resident killer whales, yet they're thriving. To put it into perspective, since 2012, there have been 80 new calves born into different transient family groups. Now, to really break this down, that's 80 baby whales, while the southern resident killer whales, their entire population is at 74. More successful calves have been born to the transients than we have in residents. There's one major difference between the residents and the transients, and that's prey availability. The transients are dependent on this food source that's thriving and growing, as where the residents are dependent on a food source that's in decline. So I think if it's one thing that we can really take away from the comparison of residents and transients, is the fact that they need food. They need food to survive, and if we're going to recover this species, we have to protect their food source. The thing about extinction is it's forever, but endangered means that there's still time. We need to be their voice.